Hello and welcome to Dalhousie Memorial Arena. I'm Jennifer Casey. The Dalhousie Women's Hockey Tigers are just hitting the ice. They're playing the St. FX X-Men. These two teams met just 2 weeks ago, the result of 5-1 loss for the Dalhousie Tigers, but the Tigers are rolling. They won their home opener last week with a 4-3 win over UPEI. Starting in nets to the right of me, Dalhousie's Brittany McMacken. McMacken stood on her head last game, making several saves, keeping them in the game for a 4-3 win. To the left of me, we've got Katie Greenway with St. FX. She was in nets for the last St. FX win over Dalhousie. That game was in Antigonish. X getting a bit of a cheer as they come to the ice. Seems like there's some X fans in the crowd. Starting lineups for the Tigers, we've got number 44, Rebecca Smith on forward. She's from Niagara Falls, Ontario. Just joining me here in the booth is Dalhousie defenseman Izzy Germain. She's not dressed for today. She'll be doing color with me in the booth here. There you have it, the national anthem. All right, how's it been, Izzy?
It's a long week of practice, but I think we're ready, so.
Now, as I was mentioning in the opening, these two teams played 2 weeks ago, and it was a 5-1 loss for the Tigers. What's the key to the Tigers winning this game today?
It's pressure. I mean, St. FX isn't used to pressure, and they outbeat their opponents almost, I mean, every game. They're undoubtedly, again, one of the top teams in the nation. So it's tough to come into a game knowing all those stats, but you got to work hard and you got to forecheck, and you can irritate this team very easily. So hopefully, you know, staying out of the box, I know that's been a problem for us, but not giving them that opportunity and giving ourselves that opportunity of a power player too by just, you know, getting under their skin a bit.
And the Tigers are 4-for-18 on the power play, X just 1-for-11. So those are some stats working in Dal's favor. And how huge was that win last week?
It was huge. I mean, it's our home opener, so it gives us a lot of momentum, and it gives us, you know, a good week of practice, and, you know, everyone's on a high right now. But we got to focus on this game, and even if we don't come out with an outcome that we want in the first, we got to keep going. There's three periods, and, you know, the third is usually our best period, but we want to start off strong against X especially.
All right, opening faceoff, Sarah McVay in for the faceoff for Dalhousie. Here we go. All right, Winch picks it up at the Dalhousie blue line, sends it up the ice. McVay in over the blue line, picked up by St. FX. They bring it the other way. McDonald carrying it over the blue line of the Dalhousie line. And McVay picks it back up. Passes it up over the red line, interception. X X dumps it in, not far enough. It's sent back into the neutral zone. Downey sends it in. Stop by McMackin. Easy stop there. Poked through by Sarah Robichaud. She's chasing up in the deep in the X zone. Scramble. Here comes Leah Boucher up the wing. Shot misses the net. Dalhousie picks it up in the corner and sends it back around their own net. X puts it back to their point. Big shot from the point. Gets through. McMackin freezes it. Quick start to the game here.
Yeah, I mean, they've started right off the bat with their top line. You'll see Janelle Parent and Alex Normore, their dynasty team together. They're amazing to watch in their passing and their shooting, but you got to keep someone on them at all times because they're dangerous anywhere on the ice.
Normore with 2 goals already this season in just 2 games.
Yeah, she won the AUS Rookie of the Year last year, so definitely a strong player to look out for.
All right, puck is sent down into the X zone. Dalhousie puts a bit of a change out there. Jenna Curry puts it up for Robin Mullen. She brings it over the line, puts the shot on net, and it's stopped by Katie Greenway. That's her first play with the puck today. Face off to the left of Katie Greenway. X wins it, brings it up, but it's stopped at the point by Winch. X loses it in the neutral zone, and Jenna Curry puts it in over the blue line. It's offside.
That's a good display there of the kind of pressure we want from our defense, you know, right off on the blue line, and X kind of loses the puck right away because they're used to having the middle wide open and getting those long passes. So
LeBlanc for the faceoff. She puts it to the side. Jenna Curry pops it into the zone. LeBlanc gives chase. Jenna Curry picks it up in the X zone. She turns, puts it in front, nobody there. Matheson chases the puck in the neutral zone. She wins that battle. Sent up ice, but X picks it off. X going for a change now. Winch with it behind her own net. Pass is missed. All right, and here comes Matheson up the blue line, past the red line. Shot is deflected in front of the net. She skates off for a change. Play along the boards. McMillan picks it off at the neutral zone. She's skating. She's with speed, going in on the net. Shot. Can't put it away. Miranda McMillan with the puck again. She's got 2 girls on her, still has the puck. Smith with it along the boards. Dalhousie buzzing right now in the X zone.
This is great forecheck right now, and this is exactly what we want. You can see Santa Fex already is scrambling.
And Katie Greenway tries to settle things down. She freezes the puck. X picks it up behind their own zone. Send it up ice. McDonald chasing in the neutral zone. She gives it up. Here comes Mullen. She pops it in deep, chasing. And she picks it up. She recovers it. Sends it back to the point. Winch with a shot to the corner. Nobody there. X bringing it up the ice. Again, picked off by Dalhousie in the neutral zone. Mullen with a shot. Stopped by Greenway. Rachel Cox with it. Great pressure here by Dalhousie. X almost seems blocked in their own end. Jolene McKenna sends it up. Here comes Curry. Curry with LeBlanc with her. Takes it in along behind the boards, fights off two defenders. Matheson back behind the boards again. Here comes LeBlanc, turning towards the net. Nice pass to Curry. Matheson, shot's blocked again. Matheson in front of the net. LeBlanc picks it up, fans on the shot, sends it towards the net. It's deflected high.
That was an amazing shift, and I think you can't ask for a better start for our team right now. And you can see Katie, she's a big goalie. She's very tall. She's good down low, but she'll give out huge rebounds. And we got to put those in the net, and we got to look out for those. So great job by Dal right now.
And one of the issues Dal has had is getting the puck past the defenders. A lot of deflections. They're having trouble getting the shots to the net. But it seems like they're starting to today.
We've been practicing a lot in practice this week of just shooting from anywhere, because we got to get those shots past anyone, really.
X sends it up ice. Goes in deep, but Dalhousie collects it. Here comes Winch. She winds up. Well, that was McMillan. X sends it in. X in behind the Dalhousie net. It pops out. LeBlanc, she's got a wide open ice. Oh, no, wait, that's Megan O'Neill with Curry. Shot on net there, so we'll have a face-off in the X zone again. McVay in for the face-off again. She wins it cleanly back to Winch. Winch sends it on net, deflected. That was close. X sends it the whole length of the ice. It's gonna go through the crease, but it's still icing. X having real trouble gaining the Dalhousie zone today.
Yeah, and it's exactly what we said at the beginning of the game, is you gotta put pressure on them, and they're not used to it, so they don't really know what to do with that kind of pressure. So hopefully we can keep that up and capitalize when we can, so that they're, you know, going into the period with something they're not used to and being down a couple goals.
Fighting for it in the corner. X emerges with it. They send it up. Intercepted in the neutral zone by Dalhousie. Winch with it at her own blue line. She sends it up. Smith over the blue line. She still has it. Smith forechecking. And here comes Sydney Parker. She drops it in and heads to the bench. Ooh, a bundle in front of the Dalhousie net. McMacken couldn't freeze it. Back to the point, shot, no deflection, it goes wide. X sends it back to the point, another shot from the point, that goes wide as well. Fighting for it in the corner, they still have it. Back to the point again. Jessica McCullough with another blast from the point. Traversa picks it up. X with it along the boards. Picked up by Matheson, she brings it around her own net, settles things down, and she sends it up. Stopped by Traversa at the blue line. Matheson picks it up again. She winds up down the ice, sends it to the middle. Sarah Robichaud with it near the net. She loses it. Matheson with it in her own zone. She sends it to McMillan. McMillan up to Curry. Megan O'Neill with it. Shot on net. It's stopped by Greenway.
Good passing here in the neutral zone to get it in quick, and I think that's what we need to be better at, is short passes instead of those long Hail Mary passes.
Those
so
long Hail Mary passes are tempting, aren't they, though?
They are very tempting, but they're very easy to pick off, too.
X wins the faceoff in their own zone. But McMillan picks it up in the neutral zone, sends it back in. LeBlanc in there giving the forecheck. X brings it in. Can't get a shot off though. Abigail Laking in there. Dalhousie brings it back over the red line, picked off. LeBlanc sends it in, but can't get there before the ex-defenseman. Smith. Dalhousie sends it in deep. X picks it up, but McVeigh is in there pestering, and she almost turns it over. Winch at the neutral zone, sends it in. McVeigh stopped, rubbed off on the boards. McVeigh picks up the puck in the corner, sends it in behind the net. Winch pinches. And here comes Sydney Parker. Shot on net, stopped by McMacken.
Good pressure again. You can see it's Santa Fe's favorite play. They put it up to the boards and they try and go right to the middle in the neutral zone, and we're doing a great job at clogging that up, and they're not quite sure what to do well. So,
all right, a face-off to the left of McMacken. Lost by Dalhousie, sent in by Traversa. Shot on net, turned away by McMacken. Dalhousie picks it up in the corner. X can't keep it in, it heads down ice. Jessica McCullough picks it up in her own zone. She's got Robin Mullen bothering her. Rachel Cox for Dalhousie forechecking. And X sends it up, but can't pick up the pass. Here comes Cox, big pass into the center. Mullen sends it back in behind the net. Picks it up again in the corner. Here comes Mullen, she's all alone. Big diving to try and save it. McMillan in her own zone, turns around, passes it her defensive partner, and it's sent up ice. Big race for it from Curry. Can't get to it, but LeBlanc picks it up in the zone. Here comes X, rushing over the line, 2-on-1. They get a shot off, but McMacken freezes it.
Good effort by Liz to get that puck off of Hanson's stick right away.
She was able to keep the play wide, and McMacken's going to stop those if she can see them.
Oh, yeah, if we can keep them out of the house, which is anywhere inside of the dots, then, you know, they've got good shots. But if we keep them outside, they don't have a chance.
Face off to the left of McMacken. Dalhousie wins it. Around the boards, but X picks it up. They send it in. Abigail Laking with it in the corner. She sends it behind the net. LeBlanc back checking deep in her own zone. LeBlanc picks it up. She comes out with it. Passes it off to Curry. Curry over her own blue line, over the red line. She's still carrying it. Loses it in the neutral zone. McMacken stops it behind her net for her defenseman. Puck is picked up by Traversa. Traversa brings it up for X. Up over the blue line. Sent in deep. Winch is there to pick it up, though. Sends it around the board, picked up by X. Delayed penalty here.
I think they're calling another one of those hit to the heads. I don't.
Winch into the box. Winch is 5'6". That's tough when you're playing against girls who are a lot shorter.
It's hard, and especially when they're cracking down on hits to the head. I didn't see a hit to the head there, but.
So X on the power play, they're 1-for-11 so far. Haven't been able to connect on the power play very much.
Yeah,
see if they do today.
The thing to remember about these penalties, if they score within the first 2 minutes, they still have another 2 minute minor to.
Yeah, that's right. Brooklyn winched 4 minutes to the box for a hit to the head. Face off, Dalhousie wins it. And they're able to clear it all the way down the ice. McVeigh and Cassie Banfield and Matheson along with McMillan on this penalty kill unit. X brings it over the line, in around the net. Back to the point. Shot on net, but it doesn't make it there. Alex Nomore out there, she's dangerous. 2 goals already this season. Dalhousie clears it just outside the line. Fernerty picks it up. Janelle Parent fights off a checker. Whoa, a collision there at center ice. Smith and Traversa. Smith, 5'1", is certainly a ball of energy.
She's all over the ice, and she's one of our top penalty killers, so it's good she's able to get the puck out. And
X has it on the point. They send it to the corner. X back to looking, back to Downey at the point. Back to the corner. In beside the net. Pass in front goes nowhere. Downey. Big shot from the point, stopped by McMacken.
It was a good job at the point of Rebecca Traversa to keep it inside for her team to keep that power play going.
Number 72, Jenna Downey, 6 feet tallest player in this game. She certainly looks big there on the blue line.
She's got a wicked shot, too, and she played for Team Canada along with Jocelyn at the University Games in Turkey last year, and so she's definitely someone that's very difficult to go around.
Downey back to the side of the net. Brings it in. Shot scores. First part of that penalty had expired, so Dell will be full strength again. Nicole Hansom with the goal. She's a Dartmouth native.
They did a good job on that power play, definitely moving the puck, and one of their best assets on the power play is that they have wicked shots from the point. And so I think our forwards kind of cramp in a little bit from those shots, and they were able to get it to the side and get it in.
All right, X in their own zone behind their net. They pass it up into the neutral zone. Nice passing play by X. They've got it up on the wing. Big shot. McMacken stops it. X wins the faceoff in the Dalhousie zone. Jolene McInnes with it in behind her own net. She picks it up again. Sends it around the boards. here comes McKinnon. McMillan in the corner. She passes it off to McVeigh, and they lose it in the corner. McVeigh picks it up in the X zone. They couldn't clear it. She gives chase in behind the net. Megan Innes picks it up, sends it out. Just out over the blue line. X bumbles it in their own zone, sends it back behind their own net. Smith in there. Matheson picks it up at the blue line, sends it back in deep. Smith gives chase in behind the net. She picks it up, sends it in front. Oh, what a save! What a save by Greenway.
That was it's a good job to get her glove up high.
That looked like that was going in the net.
It's a good forecheck, though, by Rebecca Smythe and getting it out front.
Mullen wins the faceoff back to Wynn. She sends it on the net. Greenway stops it again. We'll have another faceoff. X wins it this time. They send it around their net the opposite way. Up into the neutral zone, picked off by Dalhousie. They send it in over, almost over the line. Mullen fighting for it over the boards, sends it in front. McMackin has to be standing tall there.
It's good to see. I don't think the goal kind of affected our morale yet, and we're still going really hard, so it's good to see that the girls aren't letting that affect them.
Dalhousie came back from a 2-0 deficit last game.
Yeah, I mean, it's hard, but sometimes it's almost easier when you're down a goal and you get that fire lit and you start going a little harder, but I think they've done a great job this period, so hopefully we can keep it up.
3:20 to go in the first here. 1-0 X over Dell. Face off to the left of McMackin. It's sent softly in front and she freezes it. Nicole Hansen in for the face off. She's got X's goal today. Into the feet. Scramble in front of the net. Oh, and X scores. I'm not sure how that went in.
There's a scramble in front of the net, and I don't think McMackin could see the puck, but.
So with 3:07 to go in the first, X now leads 2-0. Jocelyn LeBlanc goes into center ice for the faceoff. She wins it back to Matheson. Matheson sends it over the blue line. Stopped. Jenna Curry picks it up. Handsome, credited with the goal. That's her second of the game. Dalhousie takes it over the red line. It's 3-on-1. Big cross ice pass to Curry. She has it on the wing. Behind the net. Wrap around. Stopped by Greenway.
Subway Restaurant is proudly supporting Atlantic University Sport. Hello for the $6 at Subway Restaurant. Our soup combo includes a 6-inch sandwich, hearty soup, and 21-ounce
cake. Lots of face-offs here in the final minutes of this period. Dalhousie wins it cleanly back to the point. Shot towards the net, it's wide. Matheson has it in the neutral zone. She passes it up to Megan O'Neill. X has it behind their own net now. LeBlanc to McMillan. Back to LeBlanc. LeBlanc loses it. Here comes Janelle Parent. Shot goes wide and around the net. LeBlanc picks it up in her own zone. It's picked off. Smith with speed back into the corner. She can't get it though. X sends it up ice, where Winch will collect it in the Dalhousie zone. McVeigh up over the line, can't pick it off. Here's McMillan. She's being pestered by an X forward. Big cross ice pass, goes nowhere. McMillan looking, sending it up ice. But X comes right back over the blue line. Big knuckleballer shot, McMacken stops it. 1:10 to go in the first. Decent crowd here again today on a Saturday afternoon.
Yeah, I'm happy they're here. Last year we didn't get a lot of people to come to the games, but I think we could still do a little bit better, and hopefully we can give them a good show and get a couple goals to get them energized a little bit.
Downey with it at the point. Matheson picks it up behind her net. Last minute to play here. X with it back at the point. Downey with it. Takes it to the board, sends it around. X controlling it here on the cycle with 38 seconds to go. Big point from the shot. Makes it through, but doesn't hit the net. Downey with it again. She sends it back. Megan Innes sends it into the corner. 24 seconds to go. Downey back into the corner. Handsome with two goals today. Behind the net. Handsome stopped in behind the net. Dalhousie breaks out. Just 3 seconds to go. And that will do it. So X up 2-0 after a period with both goals from Handsome. Familiar scene for Dal after last week's game, though.
It is. We're just going to have to work a little harder in the second period. And I think we did a good job first half of that period. But it comes to scoring goals. You know, you can only blame the goalie so many times. If you don't score any goals, then you're not going to win the game anyways. So a couple more shots.
One of those goals on the power play as well. Just the one power play in the period, but still one of those 4-minute ones that just can kill you.
Yeah, and I think that's just a matter of keeping your hands down a little bit. They're being a little strict on that penalty. It's a new one, so we got to get used to it, but there's no excuse for getting multiple penalties in a game like that.
All right, we'll be back with the second period in about 15 minutes. welcome back to Dalhousie Memorial Arena. I'm Jennifer Casey up in the broadcast booth for the Dalhousie Tigers versus the St. FX X-Men. Recap the scoring in the first period. No score until about 14 minutes into the period, and then X's Nicole Hansom gets one on the power play from Perkins and Laking. It was a nice passing play on the power play. It was a 4-minute hit to the head power play. X moved it around really well, and really McMackin had no chance on that goal. Second goal, Hansen, again, that's her second and the third of the season for her. It was a scrambling play in front of the net off of a faceoff. Just 2 minutes after their first goal, it was Laking and Perkins with the assists on the goals yet again. Shots in the period, X had 15 shots on net, Dalhousie with 9. Izzy Germain joining me back in the booth after the intermission. What was the mood in the dressing room after that period?
I think we realized that we kind of gave up after those two goals. So we got to get back to the way we played in the first half of the period and not give up when they score. There's going to be goals scored, and you just got to weather the storm and keep going. So
certainly Dalhousie just came out of the gate very strong. They were able to carry the play against a very good X team.
And I think that almost makes it worse for the team because, you know, you see yourself playing so good, and it's something that we've struggled with coming out of the in the first period, and then they score two more goals, and you're just like, oh, what do we do? But you just got to keep playing.
So Sarah McVay in for the opening face-off of the second period, where X leads 2-0, and we're underway. X wins the face-off. Megan Innes brings it into the zone. McMackin in behind her own net to stop it. Winch with it in the corner. Puck goes high into the X zone. Innes with it. She's got McVay chasing her. Winch takes it at the point. She sends it back in behind the net. In front of the net. McVay can't pull the trigger. Another shot. Katie Greenway stops it.
That was a good job by Greenway there. She's seeing the puck wonderfully today. We saw in the first period when she robbed us on that one shot. But, you know, it's coming out from behind her, and she's still able to get it in front. So,
Katie Greenway, a tall goaltender. She's 5'11".
Yeah, I played with Katie in my childhood back in Guelph, Ontario, and I think her parents are watching. So, good family friends of ours.
Greenway spills it in the net there, but puck wasn't nearby. Into the corner. X brings it up ice. Innes up to the center ice. Sadie Whaley sends it in, and X goes for a change. Dal has it in their own zone. They send it up for LeBlanc. She can't get it at center ice, so X sends it back in where McMillan picks it up. McMillan up to the neutral zone. Nobody picks it up. That's going to be icing. All the way back into Dalhousie's zone. X proved they're pretty dangerous off the faceoff if they can win the puck.
Yeah, and it comes back to their point. They have amazing shots, and they move the puck quickly. So we got to try and win as many as we can.
Dal does win it, but it goes back to McMackin, who freezes it up. X sends it towards the net. Nobody there to pick it up, so... Whoa, big spill there by Megan O'Neill. Must have caught an edge there along the boards on the fresh ice. McMillan with it behind the net. O'Neill seems to be okay. She heads up ice. LeBlanc with it over the blue line. Sends it into the corner for McMillan. McMillan skating around the net. Wraparound attempt. It's still free. Here comes O'Neill. O'Neill with it behind the net. Rachel Cox with it, sends it out front. X playing with it in their own end, passing it around. Brooklyn Winch picks up the puck, and we've got another penalty. Interference.
It's difficult with these X girls. They're a quick bunch, and they keep their feet moving, which is key to calling penalties. I don't think Laurel did anything that was too bad, but, you know, Normory kept her feet moving, and that's what happens.
It's all about what the ref sees, right?
Exactly.
Laurel Charlesworth heads to the box for 2 minutes interference play. So X goes on their second power play of the day. They scored on their first attempt. Face off to the right of McMackin. X wins it, but they can't keep it in. Jenna Downey with it behind her own net. She sets things up, brings it up the center. Passes it off to Laking. Laking brings it over the zone with speed. Heads in behind the Dalhousie net, sends it back to the point. Over to Downey. Downey, shot. And it's picked up by Dalhousie. McVeigh brings it over the center ice. Over the X blue line. She still has it. Here comes Downey, fighting off Smith. Quite the height difference between the two.
Maybe that'll work in Smythe's advantage, getting under her stick.
X trying to set up in their own zone, but Smith and Cox doing an excellent job of forechecking. 45 seconds to go in the penalty. X brings it over the line, stopped by Matheson. Cox sends it into the X zone again. She's giving chase. 30 seconds to go in the power play. Here comes Janelle Parent. Round one defender, but can't get a shot on net. And Dalhousie clears it down to the other end. Parent still looking for her first goal of the season. Here comes X, Alex Normore over the line. McMackin plays it behind her own net, and the penalty expires. Dal back at full strength. Scramble for it at the side of the net, big wide open cage, but they couldn't get a shot. Puck goes high in behind the net. Normore has it. X sends it in front of the net. They can't convert. And here comes Megan O'Neill. Curry with her. Curry back to O'Neill into the corner. O'Neill sends it out front. And Matheson picks it up. Brings it towards the net. Shot on net. And it's frozen by Greenway. Dal with 12 shots on Greenway so far today. And she stopped all of them. Mullen in for the faceoff. She wins it back to the point. Shot by Matheson goes wide. Catherine Elvidge can't stop it at the blue line. It heads down for icing. Just 5 minutes gone in the period so far. Dal wins a face-off, but nobody there to pick it up. McMillan picks it up in the neutral zone, sends it in. Shot by Sarah Robichaud goes wide. McMillan sends it back in deep. But X picks it up. McMillan again. Can't get a shot off. And she's dumped behind the net.
McMillan working hard, especially in the first period too, but she's all over the ice right now, which is good for our team, getting some offense, and she's getting back quick on defense, so.
Here comes Matheson, bringing it up ice. She's got speed going over the X blue line, takes it into the corner as Dell goes for a change. In front of the net, shot. Got a stoppage there, slashing. It's like Jenna Pitts possibly heading for a slashing call.
Yeah, she could have been called for a couple things there. One unsportsmanlike, throwing the stick after.
All right, so Dalhousie with her. Oh, and they score! Very quick off the faceoff, a nice tic-tac-toe passing play, and they get Greenway off of her game. Wide open net to put it into.
That's what we need in our power plays. And that's the momentum that we're going to have to build off of for the rest of the game. But, you know, a lucky bounce, and you're bound to get those in hockey. But it's just hard work and good passing. Looking for the side, and Smythe got open. So it's an amazing job by our power play unit.
So Dalhousie converts on the power play. It's 2-1. That means Dalhousie 5 for 19 on the power play. Seems to be working out for them.
It's not bad. We'll get better.
Dalhousie buzzing again around the X goal.
That right there is a perfect example. It's a nice pass by Sarah McVeigh, but Cassie's got to get those shots off a little quicker because you wait that split second and you lose your lane. So
Rebecca Smith with the goal, she's been buzzing all game, just really like all over the place in a good way.
And when you work that hard, you're bound to be, you know, rewarded at some point. And even if it's not a goal, it's an assist or just having a good game, but glad that she was able to get that goal, because you're right, I mean, she's playing a great game so far.
All right, so X with it in their own zone. Jolene McKinnis sent it back into the corner. X can't seem to get out of their own zone right now. Here they go, right out past the blue line, past the red line. Picked up in the Dalhousie zone by Winch. Winch sends it up to the neutral zone, and it's tipped by Mullen. She heads into the zone with speed, but it's icing.
I don't know if you can hear it from back home, but Mullen is one of our most vocal players on the ice, and you hear this loud noise, and you don't know what it's coming from, but it's usually Mullen asking for the puck.
Communication, though, on the ice, very important. You know, you can have a player open and not know it if you're not talking, right?
Yeah, and we do get in trouble for that in practice sometimes. You got to be vocal at all times on the ice. And even if you're on the bench telling people where, you know, the players are open on the ice or something, if someone's coming in for a hit, it's very important.
X had a shot there, went high over the net. They're still with the puck. Bernhardt, he sends it towards the net. But they can't convert. Here comes Olivia Smith into the zone. Another icing call, this time against X, so the puck will head back into the X zone. Faceoff will go to the left of Greenway. Jocelyn LeBlanc for the faceoff. She wins it cleanly back to Matheson, but Matheson can't keep it in. She sends it over to Laurel Charlesworth. LeBlanc fighting for it in the corner. X skating, but can't get it out of their own zone. Matheson ties them up in the neutral zone. Here comes Alex Normore, but she loses it. Matheson picks it up. Up to O'Neill. O'Neill can't keep it in the neutral zone. X picks it up, sends it on in. McMackin in behind her net to play it. Matheson's there. Here comes the goal scorer, Nicole Hansen. She's got 2 goals today. Innes with it in the neutral zone. Sends it in. Matheson along the boards in her own zone. Here's Charlesworth. Big cross ice pass. LeBlanc picks it up. Here she comes up the center. In between the defenders. She's dumped. Dal has it behind the net. Mullen with it, throws it back in behind the net. Sarah Robichaud in behind the net, fighting for it.
That's just a testimony to Downey's strength. She fought off two of our strongest players and still was able to get it out of her zone, so good job by her.
Winch sends it in on the net. Greenway plays it to her defender. Intercepted by Winch, she sends it back in. X brings it over the blue line. Shot on net, McMacken easily stops that with her glove and freezes it up. Just about midway point of the game, Dalhousie trails X 2-1. Face off to the left of McMacken. X wins it, but Dal picks it up right away. Here comes McMillan. McMillan over the red line, over the blue line. Offside, just barely though.
That's a good example of communication on the ice. I don't know if Cassie was calling for it, but Miranda wasn't really looking that way, and she might not have known Cassie was there, but that would have been a good pass just a little bit earlier on so we could avoid that offside call.
Here's Smith, Dalhousie's goal scorer, in deep of the X zone, pestering for the puck. Almost causes a turnover. Dell comes out with it. McMillan, shot from the point, goes wide. Smith turns it over again. X sends it in and goes for a change. McMillan picks it up behind her own net. She sets up, sends it to Matheson. Matheson up over her own blue line. Cross ice pass. Sends it into the zone. Cassie Banfield in for Dell. O'Neill picks it up. Shot on net. Stopped.
Good job by Meg to get shot off right away and get traffic in front of the net.
Jocelyn LeBlanc for the faceoff. X picks it up. Here comes X over the blue line, 2-on-1, shot, stopped by McMacken. Two players going to the boards hard. We're gonna get a tripping call. Looks like it's Winch heading to the box again. So X will get another chance on the power play. This is their third chance on the power play this game. They've converted once with a goal from Nicole Hansom. X wins it off the faceoff, sends it back to the point. Fern Hardy with it, sends it to the corner. Shot on net, stopped by McMacken. McMacken facing 18 shots so far this game. That makes it 19. Dalhousie wins the faceoff, but it's picked up and almost stuffed in. By Alex Normore. Normore in for the faceoff. She wins it cleanly back to Fernherdy. Fernherdy at the point. Fans on the puck. Dal's able to clear it. Here comes Rachel Cox. And Rebecca Smith in on the forecheck. Oh, and Rebecca Smith almost takes out the goaltender. alone. And they shoot it high. Alex Normar with the puck along the side of the boards. She's looking, passes it off into the corner and heads toward the net. Here's Downey. Downey passes it off to her defensive partner. Back to Downey. Downey, cross ice pass, missed. Downey with the puck again. Looking, passes it off. Cross ice pass. X with a shot and it's saved by McMacken. Nice toe save there. X passing it around, Normore and Downey. Downey with it again. Downey sends it into the corner. McMillan picks it up. Normore again. To the corner, shot on net. Nice save by McMacken. Cox falls in the corner. She picks it up again. She's got two X players on her. 25 seconds left in the penalty. Fighting for it in the corner. Back to the point. Downey with a shot. That doesn't make it through to McMacken. X with another shot from the point. Doesn't make it through the bodies in front of the net. Another shot. It's like a ping pong game right now.
Hitting a lot of people in front, which is good for us.
X loses it at the blue line. Here comes Dell. Shot and saved by Greenway.
You always know you're doing a good job on the PK when, you know, the offensive can't really set up in their power play. And X likes to set up in an overload and pass the puck. Probably backdoor is what they prefer, but they weren't able to do anything in that power play. So that was good for our PK unit.
Dalhousie back to full strength. Face off in the X zone. Winch along the boards. Smullen. Sarah Robichaud. And we're going to have another penalty. Tripping the call. I didn't see that one.
Yeah, just on Mullen in the corner there, oh, okay. But it's another example. Mullen kept moving her feet. I don't think it was much, but.
So Sydney Parker heading off for X. Dow will get a chance to score again. They scored on their first power play almost just seconds into it, so.
Hopefully we can go 2-for-2 right now.
All right, Jocelyn LeBlanc for the faceoff. She sends it back to her point. McMillan to the corner. They lose it. X clears it. Curry and McMillan back in their own zone. Here comes LeBlanc over the blue line. Sends it into the corner, picks it up herself. And Smith with it, brings it around. Smith to the point, McMillan back to the corner. O'Neill with it. Here's LeBlanc who sends it back to the point. McMillan, big shot, doesn't make it to the net. X picks it up and is able to clear it. Back into the Dell zone, McMillan's got somebody chasing her. Janelle Parent with it for X. Here comes Sarah Robichaud. Up over the blue line, passes it back to Jenna Curry. Curry takes a shot, saved by Greenway. McMillan sends it in deep. Dial's offside, they got to tag up. Robichaud goes in, but X is able to clear it right down the ice. There's a rogue stick on the ice. Robichaud tied up in the neutral zone there. McMaxon stops it for Matheson, who regroups behind her own net. Winch over the blue line. Nice play by Winch to keep it onside. Power play just about to expire, and X is back to full strength. But Dell has it in front of the net. Back to the point. Matheson shot. Scramble for it in front of the net. Oh. Mullen had a chance there, but just couldn't get a handle on it.
Another amazing job by Katie Greenway. I mean, she's having a hell of a game, but
Here comes X over the line. Nicole Hansen. Shot on net, but it hits Winch in front of the net. She clears it to the side. Winch picks it up again, sends it around the other way. Here's Sarah Robichaud. Matheson behind the net. Sarah Robichaud fighting for it along the boards. McDonald picks it up, sends it to the corner. X throws it in front of the net, scores. X had it along the boards. They were able to throw it right out in front. And they made no mistake there.
Yeah, it's Janelle Perrin. It's one of their top players again, but she's dangerous all over the ice. And it was a bouncing puck, too, so credit to her for getting that out of the air almost. But we'll just have to keep working hard and hopefully get another goal before the end of the period.
So that makes it 3-1 for X. Just 3:40 to go here in the second period. It's Janelle Perrin's first goal of the season. Here comes X over the blue line. Picked up by McVay. McVay brings it around the Dalhousie net. Winds up. Comes across the center. So the official goal is Janelle Parent from Innes and Normore. So make it 3-1 X over Dell. Face off in the Dalhousie zone. Frozen quickly by McMackin. McVay in for the face-off. McMillan fights for it along the boards, almost takes out the ref along with her. Olivia Smith passes it out. Dalhousie breaks out of their own zone. Here comes Cox. Cox loses it in the neutral zone. Sydney Parker brings it over the line. She's alone, though. Dalhousie collects it behind their own nets. Laurel Charlesworth with it. X is going to pick it up at the blue line. Here comes Hansen. Hansen in behind the net. Fights off the checker. Back to her point. .213 to go here in the second. Hansen picks it up, passes it off. Shot on net, goes wide. Shot in front. Oh. Not a lot of chance there for McMackin. She's kind of left out hanging by herself.
Yeah, you got to give credit to St. FX again. They put the pressure on and they don't stop. And they're talented with the puck. I mean, every single one of their players can maneuver it. And yeah, nice little pass. She didn't even look. She just knew that her player would be there. And so it's a good job for them getting traffic in front and shooting on McMackin. I mean, they have 25 shots in two periods, which you're bound to get a couple goals out of that. So.
Abigail Laking with the goal. Hansen with an assist. Hansen having an excellent game for X. Two goals and an assist. Dalhousie has it in the X zone. Matheson carries it back into the neutral zone. Passes it off to Winch. Winch sends it in deep. Minute 28 to go here in the second period. X sends it to the center, but can't get it out. Shot on net. Up high, and Greenway stops it. Dalhousie's been putting a lot of shots on net as well. 21 shots so far, just two periods in, so.
Yeah, I mean, it comes down to traffic in front of the net. Katie, I think, is seeing a lot more of the shots. And they're a lot easier for her to grab that way. So hopefully we can get someone in front of the net, screen her a little bit, get some rebounds out like we mentioned in the first period, and capitalize on those opportunities.
X with it in their own zone. They bring it up over the blue line. Into the Dalhousie zone with speed around the wing. Molly McDonald with it. Minute to go here in the second period. Back to the point. Shot. Hit something in front and goes to the corner. Scramble, shot on net again. McMackin with the save. Janelle Parent certainly finds the space on the ice.
She does, and I mean, you mentioned it was her first goal of the season, but I'm sure she has a lot of assist off of Normore's couple goals. She's everywhere, and she makes beautiful passes, but when she has an opportunity to shoot, she takes it every time. So.
And coming into today's game, she's got 10 shots on goal. That's more than anybody else on her team. She certainly does take a lot of shots, and
yes,
the more
she does.
Shots you take, the more you're going to score.
And it pays off, too, because she does get a lot of points by the end of the season.
30 seconds here to go in the second period. X has it in their own zone, but stopped at the point by Dal. Dal sends it in on net, bouncing puck, put away by Greenway. Smith with it in the corner. Smith, Dal's lone goal scorer, sends it out front, stopped by Greenway. Wraparound attempt. Can't stuff it in. 4 seconds to go here in the second period.
So I think Santa Fex is going to go off for one of those famous hit-to-the-head penalties.
We certainly have seen quite a few of those this season.
Yeah, and I think we were talking, too, in the middle of the period. You got to be careful with those calls. They are four-minute penalties, but you want to make sure you're calling them at the right time. You know, I think off the boards, you got boarding, body checking, stuff like that. You want to call these penalties more when they're open ice hits and they're direct hits to the head. So maybe a little liberal in this game, but it's important to get those out of the game, so maybe that's what they're trying to do.
Sydney Parker goes off for 4 minutes for St. Effects, so Dell, unless they can score in the next 1.2 seconds, will start the third period with a power play.
Downey acting as a second goalie there on that play.
Here's the blow-in for the faceoff. Tied up in some feet, and there goes the buzzer. So Dalhousie heading to the dressing room down 4-1, but they're going to start the third period with a 3-minute and 56 power play. How important would it be to come out and get a goal right off the bat?
You almost want to try and do what we did on the first power play and get a goal right away so that we have another power play in that 2 minutes. But we can't get, I think morale is getting a little low right now. We can't get too physical, and we got to go and score goals instead. So hopefully we can get that done and get this game back in motion and, you know, make it a close game for them.
All right, we'll be back with the third period in 15 minutes. Thanks, Izzy. and welcome back to Dalhousie Memorial Arena, where the Dalhousie women's Tigers hockey team is taking on the St. FX X-Men. Let's start with your scoring recap. The X-Men are leading 4-1. First period, we had Nicole Hansen. Two goals for Nicole in the first period. She scored the first one 14-25 on the power play. Nice tic-tac-toe passing play from Perkins and Laking. Then her second goal came right off the face-off, a scramble in front of the net. Hansen with the goal, Laking and Perkins again with the assist. That was at 16:53. Then in the second period, Dalhousie cut that lead in half with a goal by Rebecca Smith. Rebecca Smith was just buzzing all around the ice today. It was just a matter of time before she got a goal. This one on the power play, and it was just seconds into the Dalhousie power play. Nice pass from Megan O'Neill and Miranda McMillan, and Rebecca was just in the right place at the right time to pop it into the open net. But it was all X for the rest of the period. Janelle Parent gets her first of the season, first of probably many coming up this season. She gets assists from Megan Innes and Alex Normore. X gets another one before the period would end from Abigail Laking, and she gets the assist from Nicole Hansen, who threw the puck. She was along the corner of the boards, threw it right out front, and Laking was able to pop it in the net. Shots in the game so far. X has 26 shots on net. Dal with 22 shots on net. Power play so far, X converted on that first power play they had. They're 1-for-3. Dalhousie is 1-for-2 so far. However, they're gonna start the third period with a 4-minute power play. St. FX's Sydney Parker is in the box for another one of those hit to the head penalties. We're seeing quite a bit of those this season. The refs have been told to crack down on any contact to the head, so we're seeing quite a few, especially between players who are very tall and against players who are very short. They're definitely cracking down on that type of contact. So here come the Tigers onto the ice. The line of Rebecca Smith, Jocelyn LeBlanc, and Megan O'Neill will start the period. Back on defense, Jenna Curry and Melinda McMillan. All right, back in the booth, we've got Izzy Germain. Just as X hits the ice for the third period. So you're down 4-1, but you've got that power play to start the period. What was the mood like in the dressing room?
I mean, we know coming into this game that X is a good team, but I think a good message to send to them is that we don't give up, and, you know, we can put on a good game for them. So, you know, Coach Frazier kind of emphasized that I don't think the score is a good testimony to what the game is right now, but if we can get a couple quick ones and finish the game off strong and win this period, then we can send a message to the league that we're definitely a contender for that top spot.
Alright, so as I said, Sydney Parker's in the box for that 4-minute hitting to the head penalty. We'll have Jocelyn LeBlanc in for the opening face-off of the period. Remind you that Dell's next home game is next Saturday, November 5th against UPEI at 7 o'clock. All right, so Dell wins the faceoff. McMillan sends it up ice for LeBlanc. LeBlanc into the corner. She's got speed in behind the net. Passes it off to O'Neill. O'Neill back to LeBlanc. O'Neill takes it in the corner. LeBlanc picks it up in the corner. O'Neill back to the point where McMillan picks it up. McMillan across to her partner. And it's intercepted. X on a breakaway. Here we go, Janelle Parent. She scores. That was a very nice play by Janelle Parent.
Finishes it off with a little spinorama on the ground.
Janelle Parent with a shorthanded goal. She goes in on a breakaway and dekes McMacken. So Janelle gets her second goal of the season. Dalhousie's gonna have to regroup from that.
It's hard when you get shorthanded goals right off the bat, but we've still got this penalty, so hopefully we can get a goal at least.
5-1 the score for X. 3 minutes to go, though, in the Dalhousie power play. Dal picks it up in their own zone. Mullen brings it up with Robichaud. Robichaud over the line. Robichaud stands. Matheson pokes it through. Here comes Robichaud. Shot. Stopped by Greenway. Mullen in for the face-off. X wins it, sends it around the net. Winch with a bit of a hit there along the boards. Matheson picks it up in her own zone. Behind her own net. She sends it up. Mullen brings it up the ice. Loses it in the neutral zone. Matheson back to collect it. Matheson sends it up along the boards. Here comes O'Neill with speed along the boards, over the blue line, up the wing, into the corner. She's bumped by Downey, and Downey's gonna head to the box for that. So Dell has a huge chance right now, 5-on-3 for a full 2 minutes.
Yeah, this is a gift right now. That's a little dangerous play by Downey. You want to keep your stick off of someone's back, especially when their head's close to the boards, but looks like we'll be calling a timeout.
Do you talk about a strategy, a certain play, or do you just sort of kind of rally the troops?
I think we got to calm down a bit, and I think that's the biggest message. You know, we might be a little too antsy to get that next goal, but you got to do it right, and you got to take the necessary steps to do that. So, you know, giving them a little bit of advice, but telling them to slow it down, and you've got 2 minutes, and 2 minutes is a lot of time, especially 5-on-3. So I would think Coach Frazier really is right now trying to rally them up.
All right, timeout over. The three X-Men head back on. And Coach Frazier has pulled McMacken and put in favor of putting six players on the ice.
I've never seen that before.
I'd have to say, out of all the hockey I've watched, I've never seen it either. X sends the puck down the and it just misses the net. Whew. So here comes Miranda McMillan up the ice, over the blue line. Nice deke around the defenseman. She's got it behind the net. Here comes LeBlanc in front of the net. Shot, can't convert. Scramble in front of the net. They're back, they're way at it. It looks like Dal might get called for a penalty here. It's going to be slashing, I believe.
I think that's one too many shots by Jocelyn trying to get the puck out of Greenway's pads. But again, shutting the door, and she's having an amazing game. So down low, up high.
So LeBlanc into the box, McMacken back into the net. So we're going to play 4-on-3. This is pond hockey.
I would hope they put the goalie back. I've never seen that before.
A lot of space out there. McMillan in behind her own net. She looks around to set up the play. Decides to bring it up herself, passes it off to Curry. Curry over the blue line with speed. She gets around the defenseman. Shot on net, and she misses wide. Here's Matheson. Matheson loses it. Back to McMillan. X changes. Here's Curry. She sends it in. Mullen goes in after it. Here comes Innes for X. Sends it up ice. McMillan around the net for Matheson. Big cross ice pass. It's missed by O'Neill, but she's still going in with speed. Picked up in the zone. Thrown out front, but no Dal player to pick it up. Kathy Banfield out there. Here comes Winch behind her own net. First penalty about to expire for X. We're going to have 4-on-4 for about 30 seconds. There goes one penalty. And here comes the second X player. So X on the power play for about 30 seconds. Intercepted by Dell at the blue line. Banfield in behind the X net. 8 seconds to go in the X power play. They bring it up over the red line, over the blue line. Shot on net, McMacken stops it. X with it behind the net again, LeBlanc. Picks up the puck. Winch throws it forward for LeBlanc. She can't get it. X throws it in deep. McMacken stops it for McMillan. McMillan around the net. Smith misses it at the blue line. Here's Curry. Innes with it behind the net. Charlesworth. Smith fighting in the neutral zone for it. Curry throws it into some traffic. Here comes Sydney Parker for X. She throws it up for Leah Boucher. Offside, they've got a tag up. Picked off by Mullen at the blue line. Matheson, cross ice. Robichaud in for it, she can't get at it. Matheson back in her own zone to regroup. Cox misses it. Rebecca Traversa in her own zone sends the big two-line pass up. X shot misses.
That's Sandifex's favorite play to do, is get it right up the middle, and they get a cherry picker up near the blue line right off of their change. So it was a good vision by Rebecca Traversa to see that pass.
Here comes Sarah McVay over the blue line. Just misses the net wide. Winch pinches and misses it. It's a 3-on-1. Pass across, missed by X. They get it back to the point where Downey has it. She sends it in deep again. Banking away at it at the net. Alex Normore out there. Here comes Downey. Skating towards the net, throws it on net, misses wide. She picks it up again in the corner. Back to Innes. Innes throws it towards the net. Gets stopped in front. And Dal is just going to send it down ice, get a change. But here comes Downey. Big shot over the head of McMacken. What a zinger she has.
It's a strong shot.
All right, here comes Dal over the blue line. Pass in front. Greenway stops it. Greenway facing 24 shots so far today. She's been solid.
Yeah, great performance, and that's what you want, when, especially when we came out like that in the first period. You want to have confidence in your goalie to stop the puck, and she's done that for the St. FX team for sure.
So here's LeBlanc in for the faceoff. LeBlanc, she wins it. But X comes out with it. Brittany Perkins in for it. She's got a couple of assists already today. Intercepted in the neutral zone by X. Here comes Hansen. O'Neill up to LeBlanc. LeBlanc over the blue line. Around the defender, but she loses it. Here comes Brittany Perkins again. And Hansen over the blue line, picked off by Dell. Dell seemed like a little bit of a miscommunication there in their own zone. Here comes Sarah Robichaud, bringing it up over the X blue line. She's got Mullen with her. Throws it towards the net. Rebound by Greenway, but nobody there. Big shot from the point by Winch. They throw it towards the net. They're batting away at it, but they can't put it in. Robichaud with it in the corner. Sadie Whaley's going to pick it up in the corner for X, but it's kept in by Catherine Elvidge. Here comes X again. Sadie Whaley. Shot stopped. And it hits the netting, so we're going to face off there. And 10:50 to go here in the third period. X leads Dal 5-1. McMackin. X wins it, sends it back to the point. We've got it behind the net. Downey stops it at the point. Shot by Innes is blocked. Shot tipped, misses the net. Smith throws it back in behind her own net. Cox picks it up, sends it up ice. There's Banfield with it. X picks it up in the center. Janelle Parent giving chase as Dell throws it towards the blue line. It's intercepted. Parent with it in the corner. Smith checks. Smith sends it up ice for LeBlanc. LeBlanc can't get it. Stopped at the blue line by Matheson.
That was a good job by Liz to step up and force the offside there so we can get quick change and a face-off outside of our zone.
The Dalhousie blue line. Handsome in for it. She loses it. Here's Matheson. Matheson circling around. Gets deflected into her own zone where Winch picks it up. And it's stolen by X. They throw it on net. McMackin stops it. Shots on net for X as they take the face-off in the Dalhousie zone. Winch takes it back for Dalhousie. Sends it into the neutral zone. X is able to throw it back in where Matheson collects it behind her own net. Curry sends it up the middle. Jessica McCullough sends it up for X, but it's intercepted by Dal. Dal brings it back into the zone. Throw it in front of the net. Oh, LeBlanc can't get the puck up high enough to get it over Greenway. And Greenway is able to stop that puck once again. All right, so Mullen in for the faceoff for Dalhousie. She wins it back. They throw it to the point for McMillan. Gets deflected into the corner where Mullen picks it up again. She throws it behind the net. Dalhousie player falls in the corner. X throws it in deep. Here comes McMillan with speed. Can't get it over the X blue line. Robichaud picks it up, sends it in. X sends it up the middle and it's stopped. And Sydney Parker sends it in deep. Get a full line change here for X. Sends it at the center, at the blue line for Normore. She throws it out front, passes back to the point. Janelle Parent in the corner. Passes it wide over to the other side. Tip shot, misses high. Here comes Sarah McVeigh over the line. Janelle Parent passes it off, and then they miss wide. Shot from the point, misses wide again. Brittany Perkins passes it off to Traversa. Dalhousie finally collects it, and they've got it behind their own net. Here comes McMillan. Big pass over the blue line. Here comes LeBlanc over the blue line. In towards the net. Crashes the net. Doesn't get a shot. Puck still out in front. Here comes X the other way. Over the blue line. Into the corner, out front. Picked up by Curry, but she gives it away. Here comes LeBlanc again behind her own net. X has it in their own zone. Handsome in towards the net. She goes around the defender, gets the shot off, but can't put it in. Handsome out there looking for a hat trick today. LeBlanc throws it on net, but no rebound allowed. Sarah Robichaud, she loses it to the X. Here comes X again over the blue line. Sydney Parker. Dal throws it the other way. Here comes Sarah Robichaud over the blue line. Big slap shot, goes wide. Robichaud picks it up again in the corner. Matheson, big shot. Rebound, but nobody can pick it up. Nice play by Matheson to keep it in. X with it in their own zone. They send it up ice. Big two-line pass, doesn't connect. It's going to be icing.
It's a good job without a couple whistles there. A couple things to note. Coach Frazier's starting to play some of our rookies, some of the girls we haven't seen yet. Kat Elvidge, good tall defense. Her parents are actually watching, apparently, in Ottawa, so hello to them. But using Molly O'Grady, too, and Olivia Smith, and I think that's just a way to kind of get them acclimated to the game. And it's good to play them against a team like St. FX because they are a very good team, and they're doing a good job forechecking, utilizing their defense and opening space up. So.
All right, X with it in their own zone. Send it cross ice. 2-on-2 over the blue line. They go up for a change. McMackin with it in behind her net. Winch sends it up. Smith and Winch fighting for it along the boards. Squirts free. McMillan picks it up in her own zone. McMillan's logged a ton of ice time today.
And it's been, she's done that every game, and she's in shape, and she can do it, and it's good because we do need her out there a lot.
X picks it up in the Dell zone. Passes it off into the corner. Smith picks it up. She sends it out of the zone. And Dell goes for a change. Here comes X over the blue line. Pass in front, intercepted. Here comes Jenna Curry with speed. Yeah, but it's going to be icing. That pass just a little too far for Jenna Curry. 2:59 to go here in the third period. X leads 5-1. Face-off going to the left of Brittany McMackin. X wins it, sends it back to Downey. Downey across ice to Innes. Innes throws it towards the net, but it goes wide. Here comes Dow breaking out. Matheson over the X blue line. She picks it up deep in the zone. LeBlanc in there now too. LeBlanc comes out with it. Innes for X picks it up in the corner. Stopped at the point by Matheson. She throws it towards the net, but it's intercepted by Handsome. Handsome over the net. Shot in front scores. Top corner goal by X here. 2:14 to go to make it 6-1.
Another X player having a good game. Brittany Perkins, couple assists, and she's just one of those players. She's kind of quiet, but she capitalizes on her opportunities and definitely give chances to her line mates for goals too with her amazing passing. So good job to get that puck high and quick release.
She certainly picked the top corner in that one. That is her first goal of the game, but she does have two assists already on the first two Handsome goals. That line of Perkins, Handsome, and Leifkin has been really productive this game.
Yeah, I think we're seeing a couple X players that are usually more on the assist side of things, scoring some goals. They're missing a couple key players, Daniela Falconio and Aaron Brophy, who are usually top scorers. So it's good for them to be able to utilize other players and get some goals.
Catherine Elbridge out there. She's got to skate fast back in her own zone with an X player giving chase. Out there with Winch on the defensive line. Going to be icing against Dow. 1:19 to go in the game.
See the pace start to kind of cool down a little bit at the end of the game, but overall I think it was a decent game. I think St. FX, even with their top players missing, they played an unreal game, and I think what Dow's going to have to take away from this is their first period was really good, and we want to continue to play that way for the rest of the game. But
all right, Dell sends it up ice. Here's Mullen. Mullen over the X blue line, shoots it in, heads to the corner. Exactly 1 minute to go here in the game. X brings it up over their own blue line, over the red line. Picked off by Jolene McInnes. Here comes Sarah McNeil into the corner. She sends it back to McInnes. McInnes throws it on net. Stopped by Greenway. X manages to dump two Dal players coming over the blue line. 15 seconds to go in the game. One last change for the both teams. Here comes Innes for X. She throws it to Perkins. Perkins around the defenseman, throws it on net. And there goes the final buzzer. So X wins this one 6-1. Shots were 32-29 in favor of X, but you'd have to say that X got the better chances around the net.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, they move the puck well and they get their shots off right away, which creates opportunity, but they're a good team. You can't deny that, and it's always going to be a tough game. But I think what we have to take away from it is we want to keep these scores a little closer going into the future. And, you know, we mentioned we played this team just last week, but hopefully later in the season we'll be able to tie the gap and hopefully get a win out of this season.
A couple of bright lights in the game, though. Rebecca Smith played an excellent game. She was like a little ping pong ball out there all over the ice and managed to get the Dal's lone goal. So.
Yeah, and I just hear she got the start of the game for our team. So it's good that we're able to utilize a lot of players. Just saying with the X girls, you know, they don't need more goal scorers. But, you know, the same thing with our team. We don't always want our top players scoring goals. It's nice to have them score, but it's good to have our third line, fourth line scoring goals too, so that when we're in situations like this, we can get goals from wherever. And so she played a heck of a game, and she deserves the praise that she's getting, and hopefully she'll build off of that and continue a good season.
We also saw some of the rookies playing late in the game. They seemed to play well. They were checking well and moving the puck well. I mean, by that point, the game was out of hand, but they were playing well.
Yeah, I mean, in the AUS, it's a huge leap from wherever you played. I mean, we have a lot of girls from Ontario, so playing either in the PW League or Midget AA, and it doesn't matter where you play, it's a huge leap. It's a lot more physical and it's a lot faster, so it's good that we're able to get them into these kind of games and show them around and get the pace of it, and so they get comfortable later in the season when, you know, there might be injuries or anything that might happen that we need them.
All right, so the next game, Saturday, November 5th, playing UPEI again. This is a team that Dal knows they can beat.
Yes.
And 7 o'clock here at Memorial Arena, so it should be a good game.
It should, and it's our double header that weekend. I think we play Mount A on Sunday as well. So
absolutely.
A couple quick games, hopefully two wins.
All right, cool. Thanks for joining me, Izzy.
Thank you.
All right, thanks a lot. I'm Jennifer Casey from Memorial Arena.